Hello, my name's David, and in this video we're going to be creating an illusion, and the illusion is that this picture is going to be curling up at the edges. Right, let's make a start. First thing you need to do is under your color panel, make sure you have got the default colors. Any other colors, press D on the keyboard. So white is the foreground, black is the background. Heading down to your background layer. Now using Command J or Control J, that's Command J, Control J to duplicate it. While we're here, over the word background, click down and I'm going to call this image. Switching off our image layer, I'm going to come down to the background layer. Now what we need to do next is create a lot more space around the outside of our background layer. To do that, we're going to head up to Documents. We're going to come down to Resize Canvas. Now the size of this particular image is 10 inches by nearly 7 inches. Yes, I'm using the unit of inches, but you select whichever one you're comfortable working with. The other important thing is make sure anchor point is in the center. This will then add the number of inches we put in evenly around the center of our image. Right, to resize it, I'm going to head up to the width. I'm going to click down. I've highlighted the zero. And I'm going to put in 4. Now I'm going to press enter or return, which has given me this size. And I'm going to click resize, or you can press enter or return again. And there it is. We've now got this extra space around our image. Next, we're going to head up to edit. We're going to come down to fill with primary color. The primary color, of course, is white. So let's click on this, which has now filled it. Switching on our image layer. Clicking on it so it's now our live layer. Now bring your cursor over the thumbnail. Press, hold down Command or Control, holding down Command or Control, click down on the thumbnail. You have now got a selection going right the way around the outside. Heading down to this little icon here, we're going to put in a pixel layer. We're going to head up, we're going to go to Edit, we're going to come down to Fill with Secondary Color. Secondary color, of course, is black. So when we click on it, there it is. Command D, Control D will remove the selection. Coming across to where it says pixel, I'm going to click down. I'm going to call this what it's going to become, which is our shadow. Click down. Let's take it beneath our image layer. There it is. Right. Bringing my cursor out. Or should I say, yes, my cursor, clicking down, I've got the hand tool, just making sure it's alive. I'm going to press V on the keyboard. I've now got the move tool. We're on our shadow layer. I'm going to pull it out into this sort of area, just taking it a little bit further. So I've got this amount of space below our image. Across to the toolbox, I'm going to pick up the marquee tool, and the marquee tool we are after is the elliptical marquee. Make sure feather is set to 0 and from center is ticked. Coming to roughly the center, I'm going to click down, I'm going to drag it out, taking it just over the sides of the image. Now, depending on the curvature that you want for the curl effect, you can have quite a steep curl or you can have quite a shallow curl. I'm going to take it to that sort of area. Bringing my cursor inside, I'm now going to drag it down. What you need to do is you make sure you go over the edges, the pointed edge there of our shadow, just taking it down a little bit further, moving it across there. That looks really good. Pressing delete on the keyboard, it has now gone. Pressing Command D, Control D, the selection has now gone. Heading up to layer, we're going to soften it off by blurring it. We're going to come down to new live filter layer, blur, Gaussian blur. Let's lift this up so we can see, and I'm going to take the radius across. I'm going to go into this sort of area, clicking on the cross to accept it. Right, just taking a look, I'm going to click on the shadow, pressing V on the keyboard for the move tool. Just going to take it up into that sort of area there. Starting to get the effect of our curled image. I said starting, because the next thing we need to do is we need to soften off the shadow area here and here. And we're going to do that by clicking on the shadow layer, making sure it's live, coming down to mask layer, and in goes a layer mask. Clicking on it, so this is now live, we're going to head over to the toolbox. We're going to pick up the gradient tool, bringing it out. Now what I'm looking for, that green line there, that means I'm right on the center for the vertical, looking for the red line. There it is. That was easy. Clicking down, I'm going to drag it across to the left-hand side. And as I start to drag it across, you can see the shadow creeping along underneath. Now, if I just drop it down very slightly, if you press Shift on the keyboard, notice the way you go back. You're right on that horizontal line. I'm going to take it to the edge. When you get to the edge of the document, notice you get that green line going down. I'm going to come to the grab handle. We're going to move this across just to fill in. There you can see our illusion of that curled effect starting to shape, take shape even, get my words right, quite nicely. There will do nicely. Right, for the other side, click back on, make sure it is all highlighted. Down to the bottom, putting in another layer mask. Click on it to make sure it's live. I've still got the gradient tool, going to bring it out. There's that red line. Looking for the green line. There it is. Dragging, pulling it out like this. Let's switch off our image layer so we can see exactly what's happening. If I come back to it, let's press Shift to keep me on the straight and narrow. And if I come, when we reach it, there it is there, that green line. That means that we're right on the edge of the image. You can now come to this and look at the way you can increase or decrease the amount of shadow. It's at this stage I like to turn the image on so you can see exactly how it's looking. And if I just take it a little bit further, just back. Now I'm going to make it a little bit darker. So I'm going to move it to the right-hand side. That looks really good like that. Okay, next. Yeah, coming to our image layer. I'm going to drop down to the little FX because what I want to do is give it a bit of definition around the edge. So we're going to click on FX. We're going to go to Outline. Color. Not going to use black. Now I'm going to bring it, because I've got a sepia color, I'm going to take it here. Never use pure brilliant white, always drop it back a notch or two. You don't want the white to grab your attention, you want the image to do that. I'm going to take it slightly into the creamy colors here, will do nicely. That should work well with the sepia tone. Alignment, no, you don't want outside, you want inside. So make sure it is inside, taking the radius up. The other reason for going for the inside is you get a nice sharp edge in the corners. I'm going to take it to that area there. That looks good. But don't forget, it's completely adjustable. Just double click on the effects. Back it comes. You can make adjustments. Right, next, background. Yeah, let's come to our background layer. So this is now the live layer. I've selected this one. It's paper texture. I found it. Just Google textures. I think paper, whatever wording was, I came up with this one. You know, just use whatever texture you think would suit the image. Using Command A, Control A, we have selected the entire image. Believe it or not, I can only see the marching ants to the one side. Not going to worry. Command C or Control C, which of course is Edit Copy. Now I'm going to come back over to this tab. Don't forget you have highlighted your background layer. So when you press Command V or Control V, that's Command V, Control V, in it goes a little bit small. Pressing V on the keyboard, we've now got the Move tool. I can click, I can drag it out. I'm not going to worry too much about resizing it. It is only a texture. I'm just going to pull that out like this. There, that looks better. Not sure I like the color. I'm going to head up to layer. We're going to come down to new adjustment layer. I'm going to drop down to what we're going to go to. I think I'm going to try black and white. Right, yes, that looks good. Black and white. Yellow, because that is the predominant color of the paper texture. And if we move it back and forth, yes, it is. You can darken it, you can make it lighter. I'm going to make it just a little bit lighter. Looks good. Right, clicking on our image layer. Coming down to our shadow layer, pressing Command or Control. Now clicking down on our shadow layer. I'm now going to use Command G or Control G, which is going to group it all together. I've still got the Move tool. Because we've grouped it together, that means we can move it around. Let's first of all take a look at some of the adjustments. We're going to come down to Shadow. You can come to Gaussian Blur. If I double click on this, we're going to open it up. You can put in more blur. You can put in less blur. I'm going to drop it back very slightly into that area. Let's close that down. Clicking back on the whole shadow. Still got the Move tool. I'm going to drop this down a touch like that from the top. Let's come to the bottom. Just going to pull that in a touch or two there as well, pulling it out on the right hand side like this. There, it looks pretty good. Coming back to the blur, just want to make it a little bit darker, so I'm removing a part of the blur, or should I say decreasing the amount of the blur. There, like the way that's looking. Clicking back on our group, just gonna move it around into that area just to give the impression it's just been thrown down onto the countertop there. If we fold this up out of the way, if I fold this as well, there it is. You can come to the background layer, the white one, press delete. That has now gone. And there is our finished image. I'm going to press H on the keyboard to give me the hand tool. So go on and give it a try. Using tab on the keyboard removes the panels. Control zero to go to fit on screen. There is the illusion that this picture is now curling up at the edges. Go on, give it a try. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Give it the thumbs up if you have. Don't forget to subscribe. There's plenty more videos to come. And if you click that little bell icon, you'll receive a notification every time a new video is posted. But until the next time, it is happy imaging and take care.